Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new, make sure you subscribe, give me a thumbs up, drop your comment down below if you have any question. Let's not forget, happy new year to you and you and you and love. So this video I'm going to show you guys, I'm going to start from the very first beginning, and that is how to take your measurement by yourself. So I'm going to show you guys how to take measurement by yourself, and I'm going to use this mannequin as my human form. So we don't waste too much of your time, let's dive to the video. So guys, welcome back once again. So if you want to take your measurements, please, I will advise you to take every necessary, in fact, all the measurements. Take it. So, you know that our shoulder, if you stand straight, our shoulder is kind of slanty and not straight like this. So, depending on the individual and how your body forms, like your body posture and so on and so forth. So, we're going to have to tell. And some of us, normally, shoulder is slanty, little like this. So, if you don't mind me, you place your tape at the highest part of your neck, of your shoulder, which is this side and not this side. This side. So, you place it. Me, I'm going to show you guys how me personally I take my measurements. You can see this gun that I'm putting on. That's not your waist here. Yeah, they have contour the both side. Only with that perfect shape. Yeah, I can try to push it now. So, you place your tape at your shoulder. They won't know not too much. You place your tape at your shoulder, the highest part or the highest point of your shoulder. Then you measure your chest length. As in, my chest length means where my bust starts. Mine is 7. I don't know for you. Yours maybe 6 or 6.5. If only 7, like mine. So you place your tape, you measure. The mannequin's own is 5.5. Then you measure. If when I come out from the tape, my hand is still placing on this tape, or is still holding this tape, then you use your hand to hold that the highest part of your, where you placed your tape. Measure your chest line, then measure your bust. Hers is 10.5. Hers is 10, mine is equally 10. So you place it shoulder to your nipple part. Shoulder to your nipple part. Then after, don't remove your tape. Go and take away. You use your hand to slide the tape. Then hers is 13.5, mine is 14.5. So from that same point, this waist, I use the tiniest part of my waist to achieve this loop. And this is part of our collection last year. If you want one, follow me on Instagram and send me a DM. It's only 5,000 naira and it's yours. And also don't forget that my Valentine collection will drop 10th of February. So run my Instagram and Facebook. So I will use my hand. Oh, that's us here. I will use my hand to look for the tiniest part of her body. Engage her, can wait off table with the tiniest part of her body. If that is not it, the tiniest part of her body. See, like, if it's a woman you want to measure, after placing the tape here, you use your hand, then use the other hand to measure where her tiniest spot, or you can even ask your client, please, where is your tiniest waist? Some will say it's here. It's here. It's one inch above my navel. If you use 1 inch above your navel, you have 17 and a half. This mannequin is 17 and a half. Then from that 17 and a half, you measure waist to hip. For those that say standard, I know standard is 8. For me, standard, that 8 is not working for me. If I use 8, my hip will hang here. Tight. So me, I use 9. Let me see the mannequin store. Do you see where my hand is placed, you know? Exactly at that half, for that 17 and a half inches. And the largest pitchicum is 9. So from that 9, this is where you can start from your short knicker. You can start from here to measure your skirt, so if you want it to be high waist and give you shape. You can use it to measure for your pants, long, short, 3/4. You can use this measurement. So from here, I'm going to measure the hip length, which is 9. Then I will measure the knee length, which is 24 and a half. Then I will measure the ankle, which is 43. Go to measure the, what is it called? To the floor. You can measure to the floor. Or if you want to measure shoulder to the floor, you place your tape from the shoulder and measure. Jesus. The other requires 60. So since we add that 3 inches, your waist is 63. If you have longer tape, like 120 inches tape, that's perfect. And I am on the elbow kick and all in and in and out. I use 120 inches tape. I think they put it in the middle and put it on. Use 120 inches on that one. It may say the same thing. By the time you get kept up. So after taking your length, body length measurement, the next step you have to take is to take your round body measurement, or we call it your body circumference. So you place your tape like this from your shoulder bone to shoulder bone. Remember, shoulder bone to shoulder bone. I will show you guys the trick where I use shoulder bone to shoulder bone. That's what I'm going to do now. Shoulder bone to shoulder bone. Hands is 13. Yeah? You place it very well, or use your hand to locate the shoulder bone of your client. Then after, I didn't place my round shoulder like this. I never come here like this. I placed it well up. You can hear me here, but I turned from your bubble up. Overall round like this. Shoulder bone to shoulder bone. Hands is 13. Mine is 14. So you measure the round chest. This round chest is exactly where your 5 and a half inches, depending on the measurements of your own. Like mine is 7. From here now, this is where my chest. Like if you see this floor that I'm putting, this dress that I'm putting on, this place that this open is taught, or this room is taught, is exactly where my chest line is. So I don't want to make the mistake of making this clothes and it will come down here, exposing my breast. So hers is 31 and a half. See, I put my middle finger inside though to be showing you guys the fit. I didn't do tight measurements. I put my middle finger inside. Hers is 31 and a half. Mine is 37. Then for the bust, round bust, please place it around to the highest part of the breast. So hers is 33 and a half. Hers is 33 and a half. 33 and a half. Mine is 38. Mine is 38. So let me show you the back of what I did though. for anything that you are working with, that's, if you are working with underboss, also place your tape exactly at your underboss. Has is 13.5. Place exactly at that 13.5 and measure. So here has is 27. Remember, her tiniest part of the waist pitch is here. And if you know, see, if you are taking that measurement of your tiniest waist, if you are tightening the tape, the tape will also be going in. If you want to snatch your waist so that your hip will be enhanced, and it will give you that, you know, perfect body shape that you need. Oh yeah, men are forgiven. And the yam nakusili is the trick for it. So hers is 25. Mine is 32 that I used for this. So for the hip, remember that place that you measured from waist to hip, 9 inches. Before you use it, though, hers is 29. Or if you are not sure, just measure. You see here, the tape is not going, okay, the tape is not going up and down. Can you see the tape is going up and down? And also, I put my middle finger inside. You see? So measurement is 39, her round hip is 39.75. You see? 39.75. So that is it for round measurements. So for the front, for the back, you measure your back shoulder from here to here. Yeah, this one is 15. Why the front is 13? Front 13, back 15. You also place your tape here for the back length, because you have bust. You only have bust at the front and not at the back. Also, you know, when you know as you like this, you have to also take the measurement if you want to get accurate body measurement of the individual. So you place like this, and that the highest part of the neckline. Of the shoulder line. Then her back length is 15 inches. Her back length is 15 inches. Why the front length is 17? 17 minus 15, difference of 2 inches. In a constructing of that, or if you're altering your that, or doing that alteration, know how to do it so that your front and your back will balance. Going to teach you that also. Make sure you stay glued to this channel. Let me say the one video. I don't want to make that. Not a look. So after getting the back waistline, you are good to go. Some will say from here, do this. I'm not going to that cement, and I will not teach you before we sleep here or give you information that is not accurate. So that's a good place. If you want to get your bum bum, you place your tape from your waist and measure like this. Yeah, I don't know. See, Kim, I didn't measure my bum bum. We thought my bum bum's left. When you have that perfect shape, yes, I controlled it. That is why. I will be showing you all these things, so better subscribe to my channel. So after getting the back length, the back shoulder, and so on and so forth. If it is trousy so that you are working with, place your tape at that waist. You know that your waist to hip is 9, already 9. Also take from your waist to knee. Mine is 24. Mannequin's own is 24 also. Then from waist, from Nalahe, why you really look at half million and four, like I talk about here, jump on. You measure far from, you will not again, from waist to floor length, we call it floor length. then after the floor length, after getting your waist to knee, your waist to knee, which is 24, from your waist to floor length, many Lakers own is 47.5. So the thing that you need to measure is the round tie. You place your tape like this. Because you make mistake. Place your tape at the largest part. 26. Then after measuring 26, he also, depending on what you are sewing, if it's palazzo, I would suggest you use the tie measurement and continue your measurements all through. So for the knee, round knee, you will be asking, is this enough? Is this okay? Is this this and that? If it's tight, you will tight it. If it's not tight, preferable round knee measurement for me is 18. I will use 18 all through to the ankle. Also for the flap, some will say place the tape like this and measure the flap. 26 divided by 2. We give.
13.
Come on, no. So some will say measure your tape from here to here. You place your tape like this and measure for the clutch line. You place it from here for your navel. From here, you place your tape like this from here to the navel point. Mannequin's own is 26. Then 26, you divide it by 2. That's 13. You add 2 inches to the back for your trousers. Then add in 2 inches. After dividing, you add 2 inches to the back. And then you use the remaining measurements for the front after dividing it. So after taking your ball, you sit down like so. Measure from your waist to the leg. Okay. For the second option on how to take your clutch line measurements, you take a seat on a chair, like so. Make sure that your bum bum is well seated. Then place your tape at your waist down to your bum bum. Okay, down to your bum bum. Mine is 13. Okay, now mine is 13. Meanwhile, I use 12 for my clutch line, then 2 inches for my band, which is exactly correct. So, if you want to take your clutch, I suggest this one.
For the band, 2. For you, the front end. And then
I say
you use
12. No, I use 11. Okay, sorry. Me, I use 11 for my clutch line, then use 2 for my band, making it to be 13. So, if I sit down and place my tape, mine is 13 exactly. So I think this is the accurate measurement for how to take your clutch line measurement. So for me, some will say take the neck, but the neck is not all that necessary because the standard for neck is 3 inches by 3 inches. 3 inches long, 3 inches in width. Also the back, if you are making for a high neck for a shirt, you use 3 by 1 inch. So for the armhole, lest I forget, measure your armhole, but I will drop down how I calculate my armhole in the description box. You measure your armhole. Hey, let me use myself as an example, because here we are. You measure your armhole round. Are you seeing what I'm doing? Measure it round. It's tight. Remember that I'm putting on dress. So this measurement is perfect for me, and if I check, mine is 18 divided by 2 will give me inches. So after your shoulder slant or slope and whatever, you get your accurate ankle measurement. So what again are we taking measurements for? For the sleeve, Eba, your shoulder, what is it called? Your shoulder bone. Place your tape, like I told you guys, place your tape. If you are measuring yourself, use your neck or your hand to hold the tape. Then hold it like this to get the elbow length. This point, Eba, know what they call for your elbow. Mine is 17. Then I will not put my hand straight because I want to get the accurate sleeve, full sleeve length. So here, where my where there is bone, my full length is 26 and a half. My elbow 17. Then you measure your cap. Standard for adults, depending on the size chart, is 4. From 4, you can add 4 and a half, 4, 5, and so on. So I will measure my cap. My cap is 13. Don't do your hand like this, so because you can go ta. Put your hand like this. Tell them not yet DVC is a game. Do your hand like this. Place your tail. Measure your cap, round cap. Measure your elbow. In a measure of elbow, put your hand also like this. Like this. Then place your tail. And measure your elbow. Mine is 11 and a half. Then my wrist in eight. If you want your wrist to be tighter, you can make your tape 9 itself, but I'm more like it here. 8. What can be your wrist? So I will use 8 for my own. So that's how to take your basic measurements. So like I told you guys before, this outfit is part of our collection last year. And if you want one for yourself, you can send me a DM on our Instagram page at DBC Creations. Once you type DBC Creations, our logo at pop or shapali. Start following us because okay for our Valentine's Day, sir. Okay. So that's it, guys. Make sure you subscribe, give me a thumbs up, drop your comments down below. Like I said earlier, this year, okay, did they sign a Facebook? Sorry, this year is going to be bomba to bomba video. Like now, we have started from taking your basic body measurements all by yourself. You can do it by yourself, like it's so super easy. How to take measurements by yourself, or you can ask somebody to help you take the measurements by yourself. Like it's super easy. You have to take measurement by yourself. Like all the measurements that I, all my measurements, I take it by myself. 32. Like I showed you guys, my waist is 32. That's what I used for this. So. And my hip is 42 or something. But meanwhile, I constructed my brand size chart by myself, and that is what I have been using to achieve my ready-to-wear outfits. And also, our free webinar on how to start ready-to-wear line will hold on 1st of February, and it's only 2,000 naira. If you are interested, you can send me an email. With the email I will drop in the description box below. So first come first serve, I only need 10 people only. The kitchen gave room. So I can't wait to see you guys, and I can't wait to start showing you guys the tricks on how to achieve your perfect designs, how to achieve and construct an outfit for yourself. I love you guys. See you guys in my next video.
You love me too.